Wow. So guys, I don't usually do landscape photography. I am a landscape photographer, but I'm usually doing seascape. But I'm in the countryside, the Devonshire countryside today. Literally 38 minutes away from where I live, and I had no idea this even existed. It is ridiculous. You know how I know? My dad literally drove past here to go to work early in the morning and took a photo during sunrise. And it made me so jealous that I had to come. But lucky on smartphones these days, it actually has the location. On the image, it had the exact coordinates of this location, so I could easily find it. Just, you know, put it on the map. And I couldn't believe it. I said, rapeseed in March? No, this is bullshit. I thought you'd taken this like last year and just sent it to me. So it's March the 26th today and we got rapeseed out already. Although it is like still growing, it's not fully in bloom yet. But this is good because it's all short and it's all low. When I was shooting it last year, I was very deep in it. It was like almost up as tall as me. But lately I've been working a lot lately. I've done 6 days a week, as I mentioned in my last video. And I'm doing it now, and I got work tonight, and I had work last night. I finished at 12 o'clock, went straight to bed, and woke up at 4:30, just so I can get here and do this. And I got work again at 6 o'clock tonight. So, 6 o'clock is when sunset is, so I've had no time to do any sunset shoots. But what I can do is sunrise shoots. But the problem is, I'm in North Devon, and any location that's near to me is only good in sunset. So if I want to get sunrise, then I have to go into South Devon or come to the countryside and shoot landscape photography instead of seascape. And oh my god, I am glad I did. And to top it all off, it's a magical frosty day. There's mist scattered all over the place. And I can't believe how beautiful it is. I really can. There we go. With any rapeseed field, it's always owned by a farmer and by the roadside. So the lesson of this video today I want to be is shoot more by the road, you know? And that's exactly what I'm doing today. I've got two locations lined up. One that I literally spotted along the road. I was just going to come to here today, but I spotted this along the road and I have to go back. I have to. It's such a beautiful landscape and a scene. There's a massive oak tree in the middle of this field by itself, with a river in the back, with mist coming off. Oh my god. I'll likely come back to that spot at sunrise like this, because that is a sunrise spot as well. But I'm definitely gonna go there after now, after this. Sometimes to find new locations, you have to drive along the road and just see what you come across, you know? That's exactly what I've done today. But my dad did it for me, obviously. And I would have never gone out and tried to do this. I always go to a location that I know, and I'm never finding anyone new. So I'm really glad I've taken a chance today and I've came out, and I'm not gonna regret this one, not one bit. Even if I'm falling asleep at Tesco's tonight. So a problem I'm having, and I always have this, is where to focus. A tip for this is shoot as wide aperture as you can. I'm at f16 right now. That's the maximum aperture I could go to, f16, just so I can fit, just so it focuses on as much as it can, because we've got amazing foreground interest and amazing background interest. And you know, if you want to get those rapeseeds crystal clear, you're gonna have to bracket expose, which I also do, but I also shoot very wide and do an f16, hoping that it will get everything in focus. And I'm shooting at 1.6 of a second, because it's pretty dark still, and ISO 100. And if you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm resetting my camera because the lens has got a lot of wall damage in it, and it does nothing to the image quality. But it does, the camera says error every time it takes a photo, so. You know, I got to restart the camera, unfortunately. Yeah, we're losing the pink light on those clouds now. But it's not a problem, that means the sun is going to come up any moment. So I'm going to talk you through my composition. It's fairly simple. Oh god, sorry. It's literally as simple as you can get. I'm not going to go for anything super complex here. All I want is a field full of rapeseed and the sunrise. Bam, that's it. Just a field full of rapeseed. Edge to edge on each side of the photo. And the top half obviously is going to be the mist, the background and the sunrise. So, yeah. I'm not going to go for anything complex. I might try after. But I do have another photo in mind. When the sun rises, it's going to side light this whole field. It's going to light bright orange. And although the sunrise will be best at the bottom of this road, because it'd be a massive leading line, it would be epic. I'm just going to use this as a leading line still to drag you through the image, and the golden light's going to be on all of these rapes. It's going to look amazing. So that's my second composition idea. But for now, just super, you know, really simple. Sometimes you just have to go simple, because it's the obvious thing to do. So I can see this really orange light here in this high altitude cloud, and that's telling me that the sun's coming up, and I can see this hue of orange behind the hills. So I'm getting ready now, because I'm only going to get this opportunity a couple of times for about 10 minutes and it's going to be too harsh. Yeah, it's getting on 6 o'clock now, 4 to 6. Sun rises at 5 past 6. So yeah, whew. Very cold it is. I wouldn't expect it to be frosty and misty everywhere, but I am not complaining one bit. Ooh, so as you can see, the sun is actually rising there. Although it is behind clouds, it's still giving off a bit of light. But it isn't quite there yet to shine on these rapeseed. So I'll wait a little longer and I can get a shot. Absolute beautiful scene. I can't see straight right now though. I've been staring at the sun. 1/30 of a second f/11. Exposing for the sky and back here. Hope this works. So I'm shooting down here now. F11, 1/15th of a second. Just a very balanced image, leading you right down to the horizon with an equal amount of rapeseed on each side. Sorry, the camera is actually in the way of the shot. So what I've done here is I've basically cut, so I framed it, so this looks like a single path, the one on the left, and the one on the right, you can't see it, because this middle part where the wheels don't touch of that tractor is where the image gets cut off and it looks like a just a single path. So quite an easy way of getting rid of both the paths without it looking obviously, you know, cut out. 1/13th of a second, F11. Focusing on the horizon. Oh wow. You are not going to believe how beautiful this is. I got my tripod as high as I possibly can because there's a fence right here. I can't go in, obviously, it's someone's land. The house is literally right there, like 2 metres away. Oh my god. This shot is just... I haven't seen anything like it. I haven't ever got anything like this. This is possibly better than the rapeseed sunrise shot. I mean... Oh, I just have, I'm speechless. Wait until you see this. This is ridiculous. I got here at the absolute perfect time. The light may be harsh, but I want this tree to be a silhouette anyway. And with my own eyes, it's only a silhouette. So this is, this image is true to the actual shot in real life. It doesn't get any better than this. This is why sunrise shoots in the winter and spring are so much better than the summer ones. Because there's mist, there's frost, oh, and it's just unbelievable. We've got this massive ancient oak tree in the middle of the field. It's got a carpet of frost. The sun is backlitting the tree. There's fog in the background when the sun is shining through, you can see the rays. There's shadows all over the foreground. There's just so many elements of this image that are so beautiful. And I'm going to show you it now. I don't think I've seen a lone tree better than this. This beats my sunset lone tree in spring last year by a margin. I can't even explain how much. So this image is a bit unbalanced, but it's positive negative space, if you know what I mean. So on the left side of the image, there's nothing there but mist in the field. The right side is very heavy with the sun and the massive oak tree. The thing about this is, it's by the side of the road. I don't even need to walk into the field to get the shot I need. So if I could give you a top tip today, go out one day for a scout, you know, midday, you know, there's nothing to do, maybe you've got work at night, but it's a nice day. Go out, have a little scout, use your app, see if the sun's going to set, if you find a nice place or a nice composition, see if the sun's going to set or rise behind it or, you know, anywhere that will be in the shot when you take the photo. I literally walked 20 feet and I've just got one of the best shots I've ever got in my whole entire photography career. And it's literally by the side of the road.